Okay, we're still talking about hydropower. And last session, we've been talking about the pressure the hydropower produced due to the height, and we use it to rotate turbo generator, generate electrical energy. Today, I will talk about another type of energy coming from water. The first one is tide. Tide, just one second. Okay. Tide power. Tide power, what happened is, it's a natural phenomenon occurred, okay, where water coming from the ocean to the land and back at another time of the day. And it's happened because of the location of the moon and sun with respect to Earth and the rotation of Earth. As you know, the Earth rotates 24 hours and the moon rotates around the Earth and it takes different position with respect to the sun. Sometimes it will be vertical, as you can see here, vertical with the sun. Sometimes the three are horizontal. Now it's important to take consideration here that the effect of moon on the Earth is higher than the effect of the sun on the Earth because of the closeness between them. I mean, the moon is closer than the sun with respect to the Earth. For that, you can see the moon when it is here, it attracts the water from this side. Okay, when it is here, attract the water from this side. So water coming to the land, back to the sea, and so on. This phenomena is continuous through the time. It's never a stop. And you can account it precisely. Okay, you can predict it. Because I mean, it is, as I mentioned, natural phenomena occur daily. Now, what we are doing here actually is we extract the mechanical energy in this movement. Water is moving. So this mechanical energy, we can extract it. As example, I will show you here. You see, I make a basin here or a reservoir, like a tank. When water coming from the sea to the reservoir, we block it. We save it in the reservoir. And later when it's back here, it is already closed and water is already saved here. What we do, we take it from the side, turbo generator, generate electricity and back to the ocean. You see? So very simple. Now, this is happening this way, as you can see here. This is the basin, this is the barrage, and this is the turbo generator. They put it here, water going from this direction. Sometimes they make it in two directions. I mean, water coming from this direction to the basin. You see here the turbine rotate in one direction, generate electricity. And when it's back also, it's rotating in another direction and also generate electricity. Look, here is the bulb turbine, as you can see here, for tidal. You can see the generator and the turbine here. These are the blades, similar to the wind blades, similar to the hydro blades, okay? Now, the problem with this turbo generator here is it's under the water, so under the ocean. So what happened if we would like to do maintenance, we need to take it over, I mean, stop everything and take it over, which is really costly for maintenance. Besides the generator, putting the generator under the water, it increased the cost. Now, another improvement came to make the turbine more feasible is by putting the turbine which produces the mechanical energy connected to the
modulation form.
Check
عليهم
check
modulation form صار الفصل الماضي ما خسرتهم
هسه check ان شاء الله
هذول خليهم كلهم ناخذهم يوم السبت احسن سكرته انا
السبت دكتور السبت انا ما بدا
لحد
لحد ان شاء الله
لحد داوم هذول
لحد داوم موجودة sorry. So what we do here is the generator, we put it outside here, as you can see. We put it outside, sorry. So we make our turbo generators more feasible. Another improvement came. What happened is we make it a tubular type. It means we make a long shaft to the generator so we can pull it in this way easily. Okay. Here also we have difficulty from stopping everything and take it over, but here no, we keep the link between them and just we pull it out in this way. Sometimes what we do, we pump the water to help the let me say the tidal system. Pump the water when the cost of electricity is cheap. What this mean? Imagine at night usually. Cost of electricity is cheaper than on the day. So what we do, we buy electricity to pump the water to the reservoir when it is cheap, and when it is costly on the day, we generate electricity. In this way, the water pumped to the, I mean, you see here, this is the sea, this is the basin, and the difference is in their height will be considered in the formula now. Rho is as you know, water density and the gravity here, the discharge coefficient, losses at the end, area of the basin and the water, I mean, we are saving, and square root 2g, g is the same, and z1 minus z2. We can calculate, as example, the power in, when we use water pumping through night and sell it through the day. Now, for economics, economic, as all other sources of renewable energy technology, the capital cost is high at the beginning. When we install or establish the system, the capital cost is high. Also similar to hydro, when we build the barrage there and the infrastructure for the tidal system, we change the location. And forever, and it could affect the people, animals, agriculture parts, and so on. And for environmental, similar to hydro, it affects the livelihood there close to the barrage. I mean, if there is birds or animals, it may be affected by this infrastructure. The other one, other source of energy is wave. Wave of energy in this way is coming because of the movement of wind on the ocean. Wind, when it comes, it creates these waves. And since wind is a reflection of solar, wave is a reflection of wind, then solar. As I always say, solar is their mother. I mean, at the end, everything, if you look at it directly or indirectly back to somehow to the solar. There are many systems. There are many, I don't know if this working. No, it's not working. Okay, there are many systems. One of them is a Plymouth system. It's used in manufactured there in Scotland. The invention is in Scotland. It's like snake in this way. They put it on the waves. When wave going up or going down, as you can see here, we have hydraulic movement. It's push like piston and cylinder in the car. Push in this way, up and down. And then we generate the mechanical energy, take it to turbo generator to generate electricity. Or we can make, when there is waves close to the coast, what we do, we make here, we build like a box, open from here and open from here. We put here in this green place, turbo generator, the blades are here. So when wave coming here, in this way and going back, coming and going back, this air here will be pushed and observed, released, observed, released, what it will do, it will rotate the turbine. You see, it's very simple. And by the way, there are many places in Oman coastal actually, similar to these in Scotland. Many countries invest in waves. Example, Canada, Scotland, as I mentioned, Australia also. And these type of energy coming from tidal and wave, as you know, we are not burning fuel. It's natural mechanical phenomena occurred. Let me say, the expenses of maintenance is high in general, but with time, with the research and development, it's going down and down. And we can generate energy up to megawatts. Now, wave similar to wind, okay? Sometimes it's calm, Sometimes it's windy. It's the same thing here. Sometimes the weather in the ocean is disaster, let me say, or rough weather. So the waves going up and down and so on. And sometimes it's calm, so we cannot generate electricity. Noisy, yes, it's noisy. But since it's in the ocean, nobody live there. So it doesn't matter. Even the waves themselves are noisy. Last top part of ocean energy is the ocean thermal energy converter, OTIC, what we call it, OTIC. OTIC system. OTIC system, simply, what we have our planet covered more than 70% by water. And this is the highest, or the just, let me say, solar collector built and paid for. It's there. If we know how to utilize it, then that will be great, and we can provide a huge amount of energy, intensive amount of energy. Now, what happened is, near the surface here, the water near the surface, the temperature is high. Let me talk about 20 until 25 degree, okay, Celsius here. If we go down deep, talking about 800 meters, 1,000 meter, the temperature is cold, 5. This difference in temperature, this is what we need to generate electricity. As you know, to generate electricity, what we want? We want heat source, we want sink. Heating to vaporize and sinking here, or let me say condense because of the cold, hot and cold. Now I can provide this through OTIC system. Here I have 20, 25, here I have 5. How it work? Have a look. Near the surface of the ocean, we use the temperature, hot temperature of 20, 50, 25, whatever it is, 15. There is heat exchanger, okay? Observe the heat from the surface. Inside, there is liquid which can be vaporized with a small temperature. I'm not talking about water 100 Celsius, but liquid can vaporize, as example, ammonia or mix of liquids. So it becomes vapor. It go here to rotate turbine, similar to any other turbine. You put the pressure, you put force, it will rotate. And then we take the mechanical energy to the generator to generate electricity. It's fine here, but we need to condensing. Now the cold water to be taken from down deep from the ocean by pumps, large pumps, and through pipes, long pipes, talking about 800 meter, 1,000 meter. Until we get it here, we push it, okay? Then the heat exchanger here will cool the vapor and back to its liquidized state, and the pump will rotate it again and again. Now, how much we produce from this system? This system produce energy in giga, not in mega. A huge amount of energy, thousands mega. But it's worth mentioning that at the same time, there are many byproducts coming through this process. Many, many, let me say, byproducts, we will talk about them next week, inshallah, where we design the OTIC system. We will see that we have ammonia, we produce some material for fertilization, we have the desalination for the water, we have place in the ocean for tourism, we increase or we make a growth to the fishing, okay, side, and many other byproducts coming from this system. This is one of the promising system, okay, or technology today. There is interest in Oman in having similar system because, you know, they are close to the water, 3,000, the borders with the ocean and sea is 3,000 kilometer. So they expect that it's the future, or they may invest in this. Now, I will stop here. Do you have any question?